Greetings, friends. This is Sonic Toast, and as promised, here is my long-awaited Sonic Game Collection update. So, let's just jump right into it. We'll start at the very beginning with Sonic the Hedgehog and Sonic the Hedgehog 2 for the Sega Genesis, and then there's also the 8-bit versions for the Sega Master System and the Game Gear, and I guess we gotta throw in the Game Boy Advance port of Sonic 1 also, which is called Sonic the Hedgehog Genesis. We usually don't like to talk about this one because it's kind of blah. Anyway, Toast, let's move on. There's Sonic CD for the Sega CD and the PC, followed by Sonic the Hedgehog 3 and Sonic and Knuckles for the Sega Genesis. And let's continue into Sonic's other 8-bit adventures, Sonic Chaos and Sonic Triple Trouble. Of course, Chaos is on the Master System and on the Game Gear. Triple Trouble is only on the Game Gear. And, you know, because of the style of these games, we gotta just throw in Sonic Mania here because this is where it fits best. And Sonic Mania, of course, is not actually on the Genesis. This is a fan-made Sonic Mania case, but it fits really well, so cool bears. Next up, this is what I like to call Puberty Sonic. This is Sonic's really awkward transition into 3D gaming. Now we're gonna take a slight detour from Sonic into games starring Sonic's friends, starting with Knuckles in his very own game, Knuckles Chaotix for the Sega 32X, but oh, what's this? Dr. Robotnik has his own game too, Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine, which is actually on three systems, the Sega Genesis, the Sega Master System, and the Sega Game Gear. Wow. Oh, hey, look, here's Shadow the Hedgehog, and look, he's got his game on three systems too, the GameCube and the Xbox and the PlayStation 2. But what? It's Tails, and he doesn't just have a game on three systems. Tails actually has three completely unique games, Tails and the Music Maker, Tails Sky Patrol, and Tails Adventure. Huh, Knuckles, what do you think of that? Continuing now with Sonic into Sonic's what I like to call his young adulthood, here we have the Sonic Adventure games for the Dreamcast and GameCube, which leads us into Sonic Heroes for the GameCube, PS2, and Xbox, and then we have Sonic 06. Next up, it is the Sonic Storybook series, Sonic and the Secret Rings and Sonic and the Black Knight, and you'll see there's also another Sonic and the Secret Rings. This is the one that was Target exclusive that came with a bonus disc, so yay, you gotta have both, right? Toast. And moving on to the modern era, we have the Sonic Unleashed games on all four consoles. Here's both versions of Sonic Colors, all three versions of Sonic Generations, both versions of Sonic Lost World, and all three versions of Sonic Forces. And moving on to Sonic's modern handheld adventures, we start with Sonic Pocket Adventure, which was very much like a transition game between the classic Sonic and the modern Sonic kind of games. And then we go on to the Game Boy Advance series, Sonic Advance 1, 2, and 3. We also have Sonic N, which is pretty much just a port of Sonic Advance. And then that leads us into the DS series, which is Sonic Rush and Sonic Rush Adventure. That was the end of Sonic having unique titled adventures on the handhelds, but then we also, once again, we can see Sonic Colors, Sonic Generations, Sonic Lost World, and Sonic Forces, which is portable on the Switch. Next is everybody's favorite spin-off series, the Sonic Boom games for the Wii U and Nintendo 3DS. Moving on from Sonic Boom, that now brings us to Sonic's Edutainment games. We got Sonic's Game World on the Pico, Wacky World on the Genesis, Sonic Schoolhouse on the PC, and then the Leapfrog games of Sonic the Hedgehog and Sonic X. Moving on to a more fun genre, it is Sonic's pinball-themed games, with Sonic Spinball on the Genesis, on the Master System, and on the Game Gear, and then there's Sonic Pinball Party on the Game Boy Advance. Moving on to Sonic's foot racing games, we have Sonic R and Sonic Rivals for the PSP. And let's just scoot in some Sonic driving games, Sonic Drift and Sonic Drift 2. And that brings us to some other kind of racing, which is hoverboarding. Here's the either love it or hate it series, Sonic Riders, with the sequels Sonic Riders Zero Gravity and Sonic Free Riders. Now we're moving on to Sega's crossover series, the Sega Superstar series, that is, with Sega Superstars for the PS2, followed by all five versions of Sega Superstars Tennis, and all four versions of Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing, and then all five versions of the sequel, Sonic and All-Stars Racing Transformed. Next is Sonic's other crossover series, Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games. There's three versions for the Wii, two for the Wii U, two for the DS, and two for the 3DS. Sochi did not get a handheld version. Next up are Sonic's playable appearances in non-Sonic games. Starting with Christmas Nights for the Sega Saturn, Sonic is playable in that. Then we have Super Smash Bros. On the Wii, Wii U, and the 3DS. Of course, Sonic is an awesome character in that game. And then there is LEGO Dimensions, where of course there is that Sonic pack, so good stuff going on there. And no, I'm not going to get LEGO Dimensions for every single system it's made on. Toast. Next, we have Sonic stepping out of his genre. Here's Sonic Battle on the Game Boy Advance, which is a fighting game, but it's kind of bogged down by RPG elements and story. Here is Sonic's attempt at a party game, Sonic Shuffle for the Dreamcast, but it was kind of bogged down by RPG elements and story. And here is Sonic Chronicles The Dark Brotherhood, the first ever Sonic RPG, and if you ask me, it was pretty good. Now for compilations. Sonic is a hedgehog who loves his compilations. Now here are some weird Sonic 2 packs. There's the Sonic Rivals 1 and 2 on the PSP. Here's Sonic Advance with Sonic Pinball Party on the Game Boy Advance. And then the Sonic Speed Pack with Sonic 3D Blast and Sonic R on the PC. Next are the full-on Sonic compilations with Sonic Classics and Classic Collection and Knuckles Collection and Gems Collection and Mega Collection, Mega Collection Plus, and the Sonic Jam games. Now for a tour of Sonic's compilations with like non-Sonic games. So we'll start with the 6-pack for Genesis, followed by the Sonic and Garfield pack, which contains Sonic games and a Garfield game, Toast. Then there's the Sega Smash Pack series, which was for the PC, the Dreamcast, and the Game Boy Advance. Then we have Sega Genesis Collection for the PSP and PS2, not to be confused with Sonic's Ultimate Genesis Collection for the PS3 and Xbox 360. Moving over here, we have the GameCube demo disc, which contains a Sonic demo. And then over here, these are the weird Monkey Ball Sonic 2 packs for the Xbox 360. There's one with Sonic Heroes and one with Sonic Mega Collection Plus. It's a compilation within a compilation, so yeah, go figure. Then of course there's the Dreamcast Collection, also for Xbox 360. And over here is the Sega 3D Classics for the Nintendo 3DS. And for fun, here's my collection of other Sonic entertainment. Here is the full series of Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog, and the full series of Sonic the Hedgehog Saturday Morning, and the full series of Sonic Underground. Here's 2 of the 6 seasons of Sonic X, because that's Sonic X. Here's the Sonic anime movie on VHS and DVD. And for random episodes, here's Super Sonic Hero from Sonic X on the Game Boy Advance, and also that Sonic Boom DVD, you know, the one that came with the game, with the Fire and Ice game. There's that, and here is the Robotnik Express on VHS. That's Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog. And here's Robotnik's Revenge. It's Sonic Underground episodes on DVD. You know, when that came out, like, that was the first time I had seen Sonic anything on DVD. So I was like, oh, I must have it! So Toasters. And now there's tons of Sonic on DVD. So yay, Sonic on DVD. And hey, just for fun, let's throw on Wreck-It Ralph. Yeah, because Sonic's on the cover and it's also a DVD. So there. Those are my Sonic entertainment. Sonic DVDs and VHS entertainment collection. So Toasters, thank you so much for watching this. But hey, I know a lot of you're gonna be saying, wait, I wanted to see all the Sonic games separated by console, so let's go ahead and do that really quick. Toast. Here we go. Sega Genesis, Sega Master System, Sega CD, Sega Game Gear, Sega 32X, Sega Pico, Sega Saturn, Sega Dreamcast, Nintendo GameCube, Nintendo Wii, Nintendo Wii U, Nintendo Switch, Nintendo Game Boy Advance, Nintendo DS, Nintendo 3DS, Xbox, Xbox 360, Xbox One, PS2, PS3, PS4, PSP, PS Vita, Tiger Gamecom, Neo Geo Pocket, Nokia N-Gage, LeapFrog, VHS, DVD, PC. Plus I've got a whole bunch of digital Sonic games on Steam and digital Sonic games on iOS. So friends, thanks for watching this video of my Sonic game collection. What games am I missing? Let me know in the comments section. Also, let me know what console you think has the best variety of Sonic games. Alright, thanks again for watching. Toast!